Hello, today I'm coloring this lovely bunny picture by Fairy Rogue Shop. It's a awesome Etsy shop, I think, with cool fantasy pictures. Lots of fairies there in all different shapes and kinds. So, if I were you, I would take a look there. I do love it. I have chosen this bunny girl today because, well, as you can see, it's not such a big picture. So it's a fun one to make a real-time video of it. It's been a while since I've done that. Lots of noises around my house, so it wasn't possible, but now it's really quiet again. So let's try it. I am using Faber-Castell black this time. I discovered them now for a few weeks, and I think they are awesome. It's not such an expensive pencil, but they work amazingly well. Did not expect that, so they are my new favorite when coloring skin tones. They are blend so easily, and if you do not have so much coloring experience yet, this is really a awesome pencil. They color very, very easily, like you can see. Yes, well, just watch and see. Like you can see now, I'm always using a little bit of a orangey apricot color in various shades to make the skin tones look a little bit more brighter and real. It takes the gray out of it, and I think that always looks very interesting. I also have a lighter variation of it and blend it a little bit over the part we have already done. Mix those two colors together. It will be perfect, I think, later on. I do like this picture a lot. She will be very pretty when she's done, I guess. I love these fantasy pictures. You can choose every color you want, and well, you always get such great results. I love the big ears, and yeah, it's a cool one. It's not very necessary, but I do it anyway. I am blending this with my liquid solution to make it a little bit more smooth looking. It was almost perfect before, but I'd always loved that, so I'm doing it anyway. I am using this bottle. I have Gamsol in a 6-stit bottle. Both brands are really good to work with, and well, blending with a solution like that is really easy, so I can highly recommend it to do so. Okay, lots of small things here. Let's think, what shall we do? You see, you have some shading from her glasses here. Let's get it there, so that we do not forget. And what shall I use? Let's have here a brownish, not too brown, a little bit of a orangey brown. Just a small line here. Keep looking at the shades of gray you see and give them all their own color. If you never colored a person or a portrait before. Such a small one as this is really fun to start with. It's a little more easier than a very large head. So I would say give it a go. Lots of small details, so it's a very interesting page to color. A little bit of everything. That's always fun, I think. Okay, here underneath the mouth you see some white. It's always there. Oh, I'm throwing my pencils all over the place. Must not do that. Okay, well, that looks good. And I can use it also around my white ball I made before. I'm trying to fill it up and keep looking at the colors I've seen. What shall we do? I am wearing reading glasses, so I'm a little far from the paper, can't see it quite well, but we'll try and do it anyway. So maybe later on, when you are not watching anymore, I will try to correct some small issues and details I just can't see right now. But I'm going to do my best to show you how to do this. I always use a little bit of pink or red at the bottom of her nose. I always think that looks really cute. So just a little bit. It stands out when it is done. Just a small part. So I hope you can see clearly what I'm doing. Here it's also an area that needs to stay very light. So using some white here, I noticed I've said the word so lots of times. I always try not to do that, but well, it's difficult. So now I hope you don't start counting them. Well, I think that goes very well. Love this picture. I think I'm going to give her some pink hair later on. That will suit her, I think. And now we can go in with a little lighter color here. It's almost white, so you can see you do not need to use such dark colors anymore here. Here is always the most whitest part of the face. So this time I use my white pencil. As you can see, it's never really white, so use it. It's better than using the white of the paper, I always think, because, well, I think it's not looking so very good when you do that. Okay, well, it looks kind of cute, don't you think? I think so. Okay, let's blend it. You hardly need to do this with these pencils, they are so soft. It's really fun coloring skin tones with these pencils. Yes, can you still see it? I always must watch and see if I'm not coloring all for nothing, because it's not on camera. Done that so many times, but it's getting better every time. So I really hope you enjoyed this time. Okay, I wanted to look a little bit more bright and happy, so I'm going to use this color again, this orangey pink. lovely color, I think. It always looks so good when you use it. And that's the same goes for this one. Just a little bit. It makes her look more healthy. Living in a cute fairy forest must do that to you, I think. So, well, that looks good. Let's blend it a little, as you see. So, I used a little bit too much, but if you blend it out in, blend it in with the parts you've already done, you're getting a nice smooth color, at least I think so. Well, we've done a small part of the face now. Let's do the other side. As you can see, it's a bit darker there. So we're going to use a slight variation of the colors. Just a little darker to get that effect. Let's sharpen my pencil. As you can see here, there is a small line of light. The same as here, but now we use a little shade darker. We do that before. And here. This nose is easy. It's so much easier than when you're coloring a large head. Then it's much more difficult to get it right. But now it, well, it looks good, I think. Yes. Don't color over it too much. It only gets worse. Don't press too hard. It's not necessary when you're using these pencils. They are awfully soft and they have a new technique that prevents the tip from breaking off. And yes, it really works. Soft and also very I do not know how to say that in English, but well, what I'm trying to say, it's just an amazing pencil. And if you look at what they cost, it's even more amazing, I think. Never expected that them to be this good. I really love them. Like I said before, if you haven't colored so much and you're starting to learn it, this is a really good pencil to start with. And I color a lot, and even I like them, so yeah, I really love showing how it works. Okay, like I said before, this side is a bit darker. So I'm going to use a little bit of red here. You see, I made a small mistake again. Can't see it very well. Getting older is sometimes not so handy. And now I let it flow over in the same color we used on the other side. As you can see, we also used a little color extra. I know it looks a bit dark right now, but that's just because of the rest isn't colored yet. And that always makes it look a little bit too dark. I have an electrical gun. If you make a mistake, you can try to lighten it up a little bit. So later on, when we are coloring the hair, we won't see it anymore. So, No big mistake there. You can always correct it. Even I make mistakes, so. And especially when I'm talking and coloring at the same time. That's really a little bit more difficult, so. Okay. I want to color a little bit more in a short time because you are watching and I do not want to get it that it's too boring for you, but then it's also a bit more difficult. So let's try to be a bit more patient. After all, well, I think that it really looks amazing so far. Okay, I'm going to tilt it a little. Let's see if you can still see it. Yes, you can. We are going to work around the glasses. I'm start with the darker shade. As you can see here, it's almost black. So I'm using my darkest brown to cover it up. I haven't decided yet which color to make her sunglasses. So I'm staying away from it. I do not want to ruin it. Just the outline I made in a darker brown. Now I'm going to use an orangey brown for the shading around the eye. And well, looks good, I think. Okay. An eye here. You see here and here, there's always a lighter spot. You want to keep that. And in a grayscale, I always try to make it a little bit lighter than it was before. And you can do that. If it's still gray, then you must use not a color that is a bit more darker. Then you have chosen a color that's just too light for that part of your picture. And like I hear so many times that you can't color grayscale. Well, I hope it shows now that you can color it very easily. And this one is really perfect, I think. But you also have some that are really dark. And I made a lot of videos showing you that even a really dark, almost black grayscale coloring page, you can color very easily if you know how and you have the right pencils. These pencils are made to color black images. You can also use them on a white paper, no problem there. But if it is really dark, even on a black paper, you can still use them. And well, they give amazing results, I think so. But I think this is a very nice print. No mistakes or funny parts, it's just, yeah. It's a perfect one. I love coloring from this shop. Fairy Rogue sells something different. I always try to look and find some that I haven't seen before. We are seeing so many fairies. Oh, I was not go against my camera and it starts shaking. But like I was trying to say, I'm always trying to find something different. You see lots of fairies on the internet now, and I really do love them, but they need to have something interesting and something new. I do not like to color something I've seen already 100 times before, because what's the fun in that? Something new is always a good thing. And I never colored a bunny with ears before. Okay, as you can see here, this eye is a little bit darker on this side, so don't be afraid to use some of the darker colors. Try to stay away from the spot we made before, the lighter one. We want to keep it that light. I'm using a little bit of the orangey color again. Orangey, red, pinkish, I don't know how to call it, but it's just a very beautiful shade. It's part of the 100 set by Faber-Castell Black Edition. They also have a box with skin tones, but if you color a little bit more, then you want to have some more colors for your skin tones. So I decided to buy the whole box, and well, I'm really happy I did, because they are really, really good. I'm always getting very enthusiastic when I discovered a very awesome pencil. Here in my house, my husband and my son always thinks I'm a little bit strange by loving coloring pencils so much, but maybe you have it also. Opening a new box of colors is always really, really cool. At least I think. Okay, let's sharpen my pencil. I'm going to do something at the eyebrows. They are very light, so be gentle. First, I use a lighter color to make the base of the eyebrow. Like I said before, I'm going to give her some pinkish hair with lots of white in it. So it would be strange if she has got really dark eyebrows. So we are not going to make that. Oh, there's something wrong with my pencil. Just a little details in a darker color. That's everything you need to do, and then carefully just blend them in a little bit to make them looking a bit more smooth, and that's everything you need to do. Okay, I'm trying to decide what to do with the glasses. I think it would be fun if we are going to give her some pink glasses, I think. So let's try, and if I can do this right. Okay, this is the lightest part of her sunglasses. You see, we are going to use a lighter pink for that. And lots of shading there now. So her eyes will not be very white also again, because she's wearing pink glasses. So I'm coloring white in her eyes also in this pink color. You see? And we've got a stripe here. Well, I think that looks good. Must search my pencils, because I did not think it through very, very well. So I have to decide now on the spot what we are going to use. Let's use this one. Okay, let's just look at what shades you see. Keep looking at the grays. Give every shade their own color. And it will be fine. Okay, here it's a bit darker, as you can see. So we go all over it, and well, blend them together. Just try to stay away from the eye. Later on, I will see how far we're going to blend this color together. You see? Now it's we're getting somewhere. I think it looks really amazing so far. Lots of details in such a small place. What should we do? I'm going to make it blue, but afterwards I'm going to blend some pink over it, and so that it looks like there is a pink sunglasses over her face. Black later on, we can really make black. Where is my black pencil? Oh yes, it's here. Just go around the eye. If you would try it yourself, put on some sunglasses and look in the mirror and see how your eyes are looking. Then you can see they do not have their normal color anymore. So I'm going to try to do now the same thing here. I'm gently rubbing some of the pink colors over it. Oh well, I think that looks really good. I'm going to blend it in, make a straight line around the eye. You can see we do not want to lose the lightest part, and here, and now we can do the eye. So we have color this in again. Later on we can use a Posca pen to bring the light back in our eyes. I will show you that, how to do that. Look now, it looks strange, but if we give it back this point, it really looks cool again. Sharpening the tip, I'm going to show you the details of the eye. Let's see if I can get a bit closer. Yes, I can. And around here, you see. Oh, it's really difficult to see it for me, so far away from the paper. Need glasses too, better ones I think, because I'm wearing them and I still can't see it, so well, it must. I'm looking for my brown pencil. Yes, here you see the side of her eyes, her head, I mean, that shows a little to the glasses, you see. So we're going to color that in. Am I happy with it so far? No, not yet. I'm going to make this look a little bit darker. I think she's got a bit of a funny eye. I made it this way. It's not because of the coloring page, it's because of what I did. So let's try to correct it a little bit. Yeah, well, I think that's a bit better. Okay, I lose my white spot again. Color that in. Make some hair too with the eye. Can also bring in a little more here. Well, it's not that bad. Maybe later on when everything is done, I will use another layer. But for now, let's leave it alone. Here you can see the really dark line very good. So I'm going to do that here first. It's a little closer to me so I can see it a bit better. That's really nice. Okay, color this. Try to stay away now from the white. And color the outline of the eye. Your eyes, you see, are not completely as it's supposed to be. It's not really in the middle. Well, it's a little bit of a cross-eyed fairy, but well, I think we'll have them too. Let's not worry about that too much. Okay. Be careful. So. Well. That looks good. As you can see here, it is a lot darker than on the other side. Here it's almost black, so we're going to use the darkest color of red to cover that up. And we go over the eye with pink. We already done. We make it a little bit darker here. You see, that's really possible because, like I said, it is really dark. Also, at the top of here of the glass, we also see that I should have done it this way. At the other half too, but it's a long time ago since I colored this, so I was trying how I did that before. So this one is getting better than the one before, but eventually they will look the same. That's the most important part. Okay. Well, it looks good. What do I need to do yet? Where is it? Oh yes, my light is pink. I'm coloring this also. And now I'm going in with my blue. Just color over the pink and the colors mix together a little bit. And then we got the same effect as on the other side. Some darker blue at the top. Lots of shading there. So, yes, it looks really good now, I think. What was I doing? Here I said it was the lightest part. And here, some darker. Okay, well, I think that looks really nice. Who does not want to wear pink glasses? Ah, lost my pencil again. I'm always looking for my stuff. It's such a mess beside me. I'm a very chaotic person, so always looking for my own stuff. Always. Try to do it as careful as possible. Yes. Well, it's hard to talk and do this at the same time. Do not want to mess it up. It's all in the details. Always, I think that's what it makes, what it makes looking so very good. Strange English again, but well, I have an excuse for that, so it's not my native language. So I think I'm doing really well by combining them, coloring and trying to talk to you in a different language. Well, it's not too bad, I think. You see your head again. Here. I'm also going to give her some light in her eyes also. Yep. And here, some white here. Well, that looks fun, I think. And here. I think she looks pretty, don't you think? I think so. So maybe later on I will do her eyelashes, or shall I try it now? Well, let's try. Just be careful and it will be fine, I think. Like I said before, I can't see that very well because I'm too far away from the paper, but well, must try a little harder. Ah, problem solved, did that. Looks good. Okay, well, let's go on with the mouth. I always surprised how little I can color in already half an hour. I really don't understand why some other people can do that fast. I wish I could do that. I could do so much more in a day, but well, I can't. I just can't. But well, okay, you can still see it. Try to carefully look and see where you see the lightest part of all the shades of gray on a mouth. I know it's just a small one, but even here we are going to use lots of different colors in a very small mouth. If you would only use one or two, it will look not so very pretty, because it really needs more shading. And well, try to give it some attention and do not go too fast. I'm using the same colors as I used on her glasses. I'm always trying to use the same colors in different places. That will look better than using your entire coloring box at one page. It will not be very pretty, so do not try to do that. I also have another one that is still a bit darker. We'll use it here. I have to step away for a while. I hear my dog was upstairs and now he's in front of the door and he really wants to get in. So let's help him. I'll be back one moment. Oh, shaking the camera again. Sorry for that. I was a little bit too hasty. Oh, my dog is scared of entering the door for some reason, so he's trying to do so. Just a little here, and this one we already used some white there, so it stays white now. Well, as you can see, that really looks really good. Now I'm going to try and correct something I've been looking against for this half hour yet. Oh, he's so sad right now. There is some white spot here. Oh. I think I have to step away again, because he is really sad. For some reason he's really scared of entering the door. It's a strange dog. Well, the other bus is coming to the rescue, so it will be fine. Okay. She has a necklace here. As you can see, you see some white spots. Use your white pencil on it. We do not want to lose them when we are coloring the rest of the skin. So, well, color them. Lots of things happening around me. It's hard not to look at it, but I will not do that. I'm looking for the right pencil. It was on the other side. Like I said, I'm always losing my stuff. Well, I hoped I could do more in such a small time, but I will make another movie later on. Maybe on my Instagram or on my YouTube, and showing you how the rest of this cute bunny fairy is going. Because I think it's a really, really cool picture. What color shall I use now? Here. Sometimes I try to lighten up the darker parts a little bit. As you can see with this pencil, that works really well. I hope it also shows that you can use a almost black pencil on skin tones. If you wouldn't use a dark color here, it will look really strange, because, well, under the chin it is always very dark. And later on, when everything is colored, it will not look so anymore. So, yes. Once again, lost my pencil. I wonder how many times that will keep happening. Lots of times, probably. Okay, well, also here, try to brighten it up a little bit. Well, it shows how easy you can color a grayscale. It's so much easier than a line art coloring page, because you do not have to think so very hard how to make it look real. That's the fun of this pictures. Someone did that for you already, so yeah, I always loved it. Oh no, my dog is now in the garden. He's seeing a lot of things, so he barks. He always barks. Well, can't help that. It's a dog, they bark. Okay. Here in the middle, it's always darker, and on top of it, we are going to make it a little bit more light. We're going to use even a little bit more white, and we fill it up with a really bright skin tone. Let's see, do we need something else? Yes, I'm going to use the Epico color again. That makes it look a little bit more fresh and real. It's a really awesome color combination, I think. It's a pity that they did not put that in their skin tones box, because I think it looks really well together. Yeah. Okay. All quiet again. Eesh, that's always so nice. There's always something going on here in my house, so it's hard to find the time to make a real life video, but you know, it's been a while and I've got a lot of questions from people. Here I see I smeared out my white spot. Let's correct that. Oh, that's looking attractive so far. We have a light outline here, you see. Let's do that before, and we have another one on the other side. We could use a slightly darker color. Later on, when I'm uploading my video, I will write down which pencils I've used for the skin tones, so you can try them yourself or find matching colors. It doesn't have to be exactly the same color. You can play a little bit with it, but just make sure you have lots of variation between your darkest color and your lightest color, and then it will be all right. It will be fine. Just learn to play with it a little bit. Mix and match all those colors together. Like, for example, now I'm using again my reddish pink orangey color. You see, that makes it look a little bit more bright, a little bit more fresh. Oh, now we're getting somewhere. Don't have to be so careful anymore. A face is always the most difficult part. It has to be very detailed to look pretty. As you can see on the other arm, she has a tattoo thingy around her arm. I'm just going to color over it, and later on we are going to give it some color. And when we do that later on, it will not be that very harsh looking, if you know what I mean. It looks a bit more real. So just color over it and we'll make it work later on. So no problem there. It only will look better if you do so. Okay, here you see at the edges, it's a bit darker. So make it there underneath your arms. If you see some clothes, here you also have some, always have some shading. So place it there too. Well, really, again, the same pencil. This was the third time today I was looking for my brown pencil. Must find a better system for my colorings. I always see other people's, they have them all lined up on color, very neat, and well, with me it's always a mess. I can't color and do that at the same time, so it will probably never get better. I hope it shows by now that I'm just carefully looking at all the shades of gray I see. And if you do this more often, you know where to lay your lighter layers and your darker ones. It's just a learning process. So don't be too harsh on yourself when it is not looking exactly like I am doing. It will be every time you are coloring, it will be better. You keep learning. And nowadays you can find so much on social media of how to do it. So just look carefully and try to find your own way in it. Well, That looks really good, I think. Yes, now you can see your legs. We have the same light line here, you see. We're going to use my lightest one here. It's getting small, this pencil. So you can see it must be a good one because it's almost finished. That's the one thing I do not like about a box like this, is that you can't buy single pencils when they are almost gone. You have to buy the entire set again to make it complete again. But on the other hand, they are not that expensive, so well, it's always a possibility. Yeah, and I hope it shows that it really is an amazing pencil if you consider they are really cheap. And even for a expensive pencil, they would be color really nice. But their light fastness is not that great. But well, if you color just for fun and do not want to keep it for years and years, it's perfect. But if you do want to keep it until you're very old, and well, then do not color with these pencils, because like I said, the light fastness is not that great. I think that's not possible with such a cheaper pencil. But yes, if you color a lot, well, it's no problem in that, I think. They work really, really well. And I think their color range in this box is much nicer than in their expensive box. At least I think so. Well, enough about the pencils. As you can see, lots of really dark grayscale tones here. I'm using a little of my dark brown at the top, and I'm going to try and lighten it up a little bit by using a lighter one here, and I'm going to use another one that's even a little bit more lighter than I'm using now. It works perfectly on this print. If you do not know how to color skin tones, you can always give her some tights and use any color you like. Why not? Maybe it's cold there, so it's also a possibility. She could even have green legs or black ones, or well, whatever you want, pink ones. That would have been nice too. Yes, that would have been a nice idea. Must have thought of that before, but well, cannot do anything about it anymore now. So I'm using a lighter one and mix and match everything together by blending it all in. As you can see now, we haven't used the apricot color yet, and the color looks a little bit dull, I think. A little bit boring, not so very fresh. So I'm also going to use a little bit of this color here also. And you can now already see what it does. It gets the grayer shade away. And wow, I think it looks really cool. I wanted to color this page for a long time now. I was a little bit busy with some other things, but I really wanted to do this one too. So I made some time today, and well, made a start on it. Because I find it such an awesome picture. This shop really has got such nice fairies. In all different kinds of shape. They have some really cute ones, funny ones, gothic ones. A bit more easy like this, but also with lots of details. Yeah, for every desire they have something, I think. So, yeah. Be careful. Oh, see, I was not saying, I said be careful, and yes, there it goes. Well, he corrected later on, trying to calm it away or make it a little bit more, color it a little in. Don't know how to say it in English, but we can make it a little better. That's when you color too fast, then you make mistakes. Well, later on you won't see it anymore. Well, you see how good it looks when you're using a little bit of that reddish, orangey pink. On this Faber-Castell box, they only have numbers and no colors, so I do not know how to call it. So, orangey, pink, red will do, I think. Look how easy they blend. They do it so, so perfectly. In fact, they blend better together than the expensive ones. That really keeps amazing me. I'm such a big fan of these pencils, I really am. Yes. Now, look, it is a little bit gray, but that's just because it's wet now. Later on, when it's dried up again, it will be, nope, shaking the camera again. Sorry. Must pay attention to so many things. I had some printer problems this whole week. I did not take the time to correct it. As you see some darker stripes still across her legs. That's not in the original print. That's by my own mistake. So, well, I should have done something about it, but I haven't. What shall we do? Yes, well, I said we were going to use some pink in the hair. We got pink in the glasses, and we got also blue in the eyes. I always think it's very nice when you use some of the same colors before. Like I said before, don't try and use every color in the box. Try to keep it a little bit more in one color scheme, if you know what I mean. And do not try to use too much different colors. I'm going to use the pink later on, and now I'm going to use the blue that is in her eyes, and I will use it in her blouse. So I'll try and mix and match all those colors together, and later on it will look very nice, but the color, the choice of color also is helping a lot. Okay, I do not know if I can color it all the way down to the end. I do not think so. My son is coming home in a short while, and then I do not have the afternoon to myself anymore. But you're looking at this now for a very long time also, so I can imagine. It's getting boring, and I will do some follow-ups later on, so you can see the progress on this fairy. I will keep showing it all things all until she is completely done. Some will be on my Instagram and some on my YouTube channel. I always try to do some on both of the channels. I do not have so much followers yet on my YouTube, so if you would follow me, I would really, really like that. If you know someone else who really loves coloring, well, maybe you can direct them to my page. And I will keep posting lots of interesting videos. At least I'm going to try using different brands and from pencils and coloring shops and books. Well, lots of things. I'm also showing inside of the books I like. And, well, I try to do lots of different things. If you have questions or you want to see something really bad, you can always ask me. And I will try to, well, make a video that helps you. And yes. Okay. I think the blue looks fine on her. It really is. You see here also such a small detail. Lots of different colors blue in such a small area. Even there. Don't use just one. It will look very dull and not real. It will not be look very pretty. And see how awfully good it covers up these gray areas. It does really, really well. Again, you see some black stripes going around. That's my mistake, not of the paint. So you must look away from it. So here, the widest parts, we are using a really white pencil for it. Fill it up a little bit with a darker light blue. Darker light blue, it sounds funny. Well, you see what I'm doing, so I hope you understand what I'm trying to say. And choosing another color. Going from light to dark, filling up all the shades you see. And well, then we're almost done. Here, this is the brightest pink. It will go up to here. Yes, that looks good. I think she's going to look really cool. Like I said, I wish I could color a bit faster. I'm trying that, but it's just not. It doesn't work for me. Well, then we must make another movie. It's not such a big deal either. Okay. I hope you will watch my others. I have lots of different stuff. Some more cute, some more seriously. Coloring some houses, some backgrounds, some flowers. Well, most everything, so yeah. But I do love coloring figures and heads the most, so lots of attention for that. Well, that looks really good, don't you think? It's really nice blouse. Little bit of shading underneath. You've already making a lighter on the bottom. You not want to lose that here around the color. You see how very easy it is to make a very smooth line with these pencils. They work really precise and are also very soft, so that's a really good combination. Yep. I love them, but I've said it now about 100 times, I think, so let's stop with it. You know by now what I'm trying to say. Okay, working towards the lightest spot. And I will clean my blending thingy and blend them all together. So try to stay away from the lightest areas because blue will rub a long way, and a little is good because now it's not so white anymore in the middle, but I thought of that before, and well, I know now what I can do with these pencils and what not. If you're doing this for the first time, try it on a piece of paper first and see what happens when you are blending. Then you will not ruin your coloring page, because some colors blend a little bit more difficult, or they would stain really fast. Normally blue and red tend to do that, so be a little bit careful when you are using that colors, and try it out on a piece of paper before. So before starting on your real coloring page. If you printed it out, it's not bad. You can always do it over again. But in a book, well, that's a shame. You can't do it another time. I always love to print out my pages myself. Because then you can use your own paper. And well, it really does matter. It's really nice coloring on a better piece of paper. This is a Dutch brand. I will write down what it is. I do not know if you can get it in lots of other countries, but if you live in the Netherlands, this is a really nice piece of paper, and it's not awfully expensive as well, so well, it's always a good combination. If you color a lot, this is really nice. Okay, so you see, because we used the white the first time, and now we are bending over it with the darker blues, it won't cover that area, and that's exactly what I wanted. I'm so annoyed by the stripes. I'm just getting a little bit angry at myself. Why did I did not take the time to correct the mistake of my printer? Well, it is. Like I said before, it's not a mistake the shop made, I did. I had no patience, and well, go ahead anyway, so. That's a shame. Oh yeah, you can see what I'm trying to do here, and that's what it's all about. And well, you also learn how to be a bit more patient and what not to do. You know, now if you see the stripes, you can't color them away, you will see it, so better go in and correct it, take your time. That's the only thing I have against my own prints, is that printers are awful machines, at least I think, there's always something wrong with them. Well, enough of that. Okay, next here you see lots of shades from white to dark. Try and look carefully and give every shade their own color. The really white ones you do color white, and they are darker, you use the lightest blue. So yeah, it doesn't have to be that precise. It will be fine. Yes, and here around to the back is always the darkest part. And here you see, oh, the color is so fine. I find blue always a difficult color to color. You make mistakes very fast. And with this pencil, I noticed it that that's just not the case. They keep on coloring really nice and precise. So I hope you find it too. Well, it's almost time for me to stop, so I really try to show you as much as I can in just a small time. We're getting there slowly. The other way around, like I said before, here it's almost white. So we're going to use it. Don't think too hard. This is all blouse. Just keep looking at the colors and just make sure we got lots of light in this picture. We want it to look cute and bright, so you must not use too much dull colors, because then she won't be. See, we make her look a little edgy by coloring her skirt and boots later on in a little bit more darker color. A little bit of a gothic vibe on a cute fairy. I think that will look nice. A little bit of both. That will be interesting, I think. Try and fill up all the colors you see. Well, you can play a little bit with it, like I'm doing now. But I've done it a lot of times, so I know how it's going to be when it is finished. So this one, be careful with this. This is the darkest one. We do not want to color all these light areas away. So be a little bit more careful with it. Otherwise, you'll have no light in your coloring afterwards. Okay. Like you've seen before we started, this was really, really dark. Almost black. And now we do have a really light blouse. Oh, that looks awfully cool, I think. Yes. Must keep paying attention. Oh, yes. Wow. Okay. Well, we're getting somewhere now. See, now I'm blending the blue a little bit over the white. So the white gets a little bit more of a light blue. That's what I was trying to achieve. Sometimes you want to try and stay away from it when you are going to blend from the white part, but sometimes you can use it in your advantage. And use a little bit of the color and blend it over the white. It will not be that harsh, just a little blue. And, well, that looks really cool, I think. Well, look how smooth the line is. No problem there. Okay, well, I think we just have enough time to finish this part. Yes, it will. Not so much light here, you see. A little darker on this side, like every other part so far. So, we use a little bit more of the other colors and not so much of the white. Some stripes here and there. Then we go in with the darkest one. And we try to find the parts that are the grayest this time and cover them up with this. Makes the blue look also really cool. Maybe later on with some other darker shade I will add some more details. But we can do that later on when I can look a little bit more carefully and get a little closer to the coloring page. But for now, I think it will do. Well, you see, it doesn't have to take a long time. And you don't have to color that precise either. Just keep looking at the contrast between your colors from very light to a lot darker, and well, it will be fine. If you had just used the lightest ones and are going and would blend them together, you wouldn't see any difference anymore. You just end up with one color. So always go for the biggest contrast, like an example, these two. And you could even add another one, a darker blue. It would be possible too, but I do not want to, I want to make it look very cute. So I do not use too much black or dark, because then we will lose that, and it would be a shame. Okay. Oh yes, I see if you got a sleeve. Well, let's see if we can do that a little bit faster. Probably yes. I can, I think so. It's not that difficult. Just keep looking. Like I said now, 10 times at the grays. Here are the darkest parts, so don't color too precise, it won't be pretty and necessary, it's not so. Just do it a bit like this and it'll be fine. Well, you see, no gray anymore, so easy to color a grayscale page if you learn how. It's the most fun thing to color, I think. It's my favorite thing to do. It eases my mind always, because I do not have to think, just color. And that's my favorite thing to do. Well, I go a little bit outside of the lines, try and correct it and make it a little bit more wider. So, problem solved. I said before, later on I will add some darker details, some in a darker blue, but for now we'll leave it at this. Well, I hope you like my bunny fairy so far. I'll show you later on this week how she's going to be. Thanks for watching.